She had a story similar to many that went like this. Pretend games and hide-and-seek played with cousins and the neighbor's kid until the day Pandora's box was forced open, cracked from the lid. But most of the time, it's fathers, uncles, older cousins, and co-tutors. Another tragedy bound to happen in a culture that rapes the five-suiters. Against instructions, she told, but no one believed a word she said. Fathers kept on fathering, cousins kept on playing, and the tutor kept getting paid. Her own mother, who sweat dripping, labored for hours to bring her to the world, had told her to stop lying, not to tell a story, and stop being a foolish little girl. Was it in the hope that she'd forget and somehow archive the file in a dead brain cell, or was it for pride and honor that she bought her daughter's train ride to hell? She was 12, maybe 15, 18, a teenage girl in a woman's body, flirts with teachers, sexually active, heck, even has herself a sugar daddy. Content that every teenage boy wants to get between her thighs, she does the deed and constantly reminds herself to stop telling lies. Her mother was right. It never happened. But what's happening now? Confused, distressed, cries herself to sleep, but stop being a foolish girl is her vow. Who cares? She gets all the attention that she needs, gets out of trouble, and passes grades. And every time, she knows she only needs to open her mouth and her legs, she squirms. Her own mother flirts left and right, lifts her skirt, and only the train hadn't been through. So when she becomes the neighborhood wife, not telling a soul how to. Was it from the belief that it would be her daughter's only competitive advantage that she silently taught her that her golden ticket was between her legs from an early age? She was 22, 25, maybe 28, a working young woman with a ticking clock, time woven woman. She's been formatted to know her worth, show her value by a golden ring around her finger. She went to a good school, comes from a middle-class family, has traveled with her parents with her foreign boyfriend, and often speaks English fluently. The exposure allows her to hold a conversation, but never with herself, a topic she's left untouched like the Bible flipped dust on her atheist's shop. She has priorities now, so she wakes up each morning ready to be hunted and hugged, eager to find one worthless enough to love her. Excuse me for being blunt. Her mother never taught her that there wouldn't even be one that's worthy, not one pure enough to feed her passion, to shower her body with kisses and love her deity. Was it because the mother didn't know her better, didn't believe in womanhood? Had she forgotten to teach her daughter that near sacred, or had she misunderstood? She was 30 and some things, an engaged woman. She knew she was fulfilled, had reached her goal, had found a man. She wasn't alone and childless like those women in the old shadow, who wouldn't listen not to scare the men away by fighting and standing up. She wasn't like those women stuck at desk jobs suing their bosses for harassment. She had climbed the beds and the ladder. She was now married with no attachment. Her mother was proud. Her daughter had made it in this unfair man's world. She had the house, the car, the bank account to prove that she was no foolish girl. And every time they gaze into each other's eyes, they remember to forget that day. Both silently agreeing that this is how a woman should get her way. Was it in denial that this was no easy route to take? Or were they both suffering from an infinite heartbreak? She's 40-something now, and her daughter comes back from school. At the back of her mind, she wonders if she's the fighting type or she wants to tell her to be stronger, but doesn't know how. She worries she'll be devastated to stand when everyone else will bow. She prays that no one cracked her lid and broke her heart. She wishes for a second chance in life, so moves it through her daughter's start. The daughter doesn't know, doesn't understand the blank space in her mother's eyes. She wants to tell her daughter her whole mother had told her they were lies. So she doesn't know how to open room for discussions she's never had. All she knows is that she's been labeled as the girl that's always been bad. Was it pride that she now sees staring at her daughter's face? Or does she understand that no amount of makeup can cover her disgrace? She is on her deathbed now and looks back at her life. Was it more important to have been somebody's wife? She wishes her mother had been stronger for her. She wishes she was strong enough for her daughter. Implores the gods to strengthen the women against injustice, to remind them that their own daughters are their apprentice.
Thank you.